Live. And welcome back. Second part, late nights with All Access. You have myself, Mike Anthony. Right next to me, Nat Boogie.
Hey.
Mel Finest.
Hey, what up, though?
What up, though, right?
What up, though?
What up, though, with this technology stuff?
Shit.
Coming live for the second time. If this doesn't happen, it doesn't go through again, we're just cutting it off. I'm going to redo this again and try to celebrate the 1 year all over again next Monday.
Yeah.
We'll just,
hey, next time we'll just bring the party bus and say, fuck it.
The party bus. Yes.
The Sprinter. We're going to bring the Sprinter. The Vision Sprinter.
Hey, I like my party bus, though.
With party
dancing
bus.
Pole,
the Vision the Sprinter. Geez,
I don't know. We'll take both of them. I like that. Who said that in the audience?
We'll
who said take both
Daniel,
of them?
We'll do both.
So again, we're right now here, Late Nights with All Access. Want to say thank you to all the viewers. Thank you for all the love and support. Right now, I want to give a shout out to K-Rock with Breathe Lounge sponsoring the show tonight. So thank you, K-Rock, for the love and support. We also have John Martinez with Direct Motion Technologies also helping out with the production side of things. For the first time, we have Steven live with us as well. He's normally
behind the
camera, and now he wants to be onto the camera.
What's up?
Last night when we were doing the test run, right, he kept on saying, I want to be in front. And John goes, do you have to be in front of the camera? He was like, yes. Right, Steven? I think Steven has a mic too, right? No?
No,
you didn't get a mic. You just want to stand in the corner. Okay. That's no problem right there.
We got 62 people.
So, yes, continue to like, comment, share. We have some special guests in here. DJ Tone, Soul Child, Joshua, Midnight Society.
Hey.
D1 just walked in the house too as well. You have Esme, Royal Slay. You have Scott Maloof. You have Alan. You have Toy. You also special shout out to DJ E Flat helping out with the music too as well. So, Steven right now checking the sound. Is everything good right now? Everyone can see
Aviars,
the cameras?
Y'all that are watching, can y'all please let us know?
Let us know if you can hear everything and all that.
How the lights? We good?
We ain't legit.
Lights good. Everything good. All right.
I think we're good.
1 year anniversary. Can you believe it's been 1 year?
Anniversary.
So for those that don't know, we started off with three bar stools.
And a table.
A table and a whiteboard that I wrote.
It looked fucking horrible. It looked so bad.
Hey,
like,
we're
really
in college.
Bad. I'm not gonna lie.
It looked like a bad porno.
It did. It really did. It did. Steven was trying to produce everything too. He's like, I can do it.
I was trying to.
He's like, I can do it. We do a porno. I'm the right guy for it.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
I mean, damn, bro.
I mean,
but
it did
look like
that.
It looked like a bad
Boogie was
porno.
Like, maybe.
Oh man, it was a bad porno on that one, brother.
No comment. No fucking comment.
Definitely.
No comment on that one. But anyway, we've come a long ways. We've had some great special guests. And you know what? We're going to start bringing them
doing?
Up. We're going to bring them up right now.
Who are we bringing up?
If you fucking fall, I'm going to laugh.
We're going to go ahead and bring up.
If you do that one more time and you fall, I'm going to fucking laugh.
The chances are pretty fucking high tonight.
I know. That's why I'm going to laugh at you.
So we're going to bring up.
Who are we bringing up?
First, we're going to bring up Mr. DJ Tone.
DJ Tone.
Okay, watch out. Yeah, to unplug his phone.
He's just going to jump.
Charge that shit.
I gotta get some juice.
I got Tone up. Fuck is juice.
Okay, and then now we're gonna bring our second guest up, Mr. Joshua Davies with Davies Entertainment.
There we go.
And
Midnight
Society.
There we go.
Birthday boy.
There we go. It's gonna be pretty good, man. It's gonna be a goodie.
All right.
Damn.
What up?
Then we're gonna go ahead and bring up next. Alan Garza.
He also had
the Manifest Festival.
Yes. He'll bring him up, man. I want to give a shout out to him because them papers that he gave me were pretty fly.
So, the ones that you want
to
give me?
Shout out to DJ E-Flat again.
I got smoke.
DJ E-Flat. There we go.
Did you bring me some?
Tom, what would you bring?
Hey, you brought some more papers?
Okay.
That boy got the wilding out. Papers.
Oh.
I told you got the papers.
Yeah, I'm
going to get that. Joshua?
Let me get that paper.
Yeah, I'm going to need us to get on some
Hey, look. Hey, I did it real quick. Just give me the whole thing.
I was like this. Disappears by the end of the night.
Yeah. It is his birthday. Might as well get him lit lit. Already. Let's get it.
And then we're going to bring up.
That's perfect.
Miss Esme Royal Slay.
Miss Royal Slay.
No. I have to tell you.
Right now. 169 views. I guarantee.
Right now, Royal Slay, Miss Esme.
Yep.
Broke the record with the most views. She broke the record with the most views.
Yes, she did.
And she was voted fan favorite. With the most for the episode too as well.
Hey,
so Esme, just.
¿Cómo está todo mi gente?
Oh, you just busted out the Spanish on them. Hey, her team is so strong. They said if she doesn't win, they're gonna riot and ban our shit. So we had no choice.
That's a lot of women.
That's a lot of women.
How many followers do y'all have now?
About 67K.
Every day I see you, you're like, okay, we're in this. I got like 70 people to.
And I be telling them, all right, we got 85 members coming. Y'all ready?
Like, I be seeing right, it.
Come on.
I'm going to tell you that
Thank
page.
Thank y'all for being here. For
that page right there, I feel sorry for any dude that gets on that page.
I've been seeing guys get caught out. Guys are sliding in the DMs.
Man, I tell you, screenshots on that page is fucking hilarious, boy. Just sit back and get your popcorn and be like, I told you not to do it. I told you, nigga, look.
Man.
We got receipts.
I got receipts. That's the petty crew. They petty. They don't give no fuck.
I love it though.
Yeah, petty slayers.
I be sitting there eating popcorn, just looking at the fucking page and shit.
Hey man, that's like the dirty upgraded version, man. You know what I'm saying? That's the dirty upgraded version on that page.
Mel Finest is in a group.
I'm not a part of none of that shit.
I keep my
hands clean. I be watching that shit like, ooh, don't do that dumbass shit that nigga did right there. Don't do that. You know what I'm saying? Let's get it though. We got our guests, four amazing guests.
I know. DJ Tone, Joshua, Alan, Esme, thank you for being part of the one-year celebration.
Sure, thanks for having
me. Yeah.
Catch up. I mean, like, this is a new year. Let's start with you, Tone. Like, what are some big things you're going to be doing this year? Sign a disco, more events? What are we doing?
Yeah, honestly, the big conversation that David and I were having about, like, 2 weeks ago was just how do we elevate every single year? And you know what? Anybody that does events, we always think about, like, as soon as you're done with the events, you think about, like, oh, shit. Like, we could have did this. There's always a learning process on that, you know what I mean? But at the end of it, though, you're just like, oh, man, you don't expect how many people are going to show up or whatever. You know, it's just all this or whatever. But we had an amazing conversation 2 weeks ago, and we were just, like, brainstorming, like, elevating it to be something bigger. And you know what, though? So the funny thing with disco is, almost 8, 9 years ago, whatever, when I first, like, told people about the idea, and people are like, dude, this shit is fucking retarded. Like, dude, that's stupid. And then now you see everybody trying to do it, you know? So it's just like, all right,
no,
cool,
man,
you know?
It's
like,
good.
I mean, it's cool, you know? That is going to be, eventually that's going to, you know, David and I will, like, maybe probably, like, in our 10th year, we'll probably figure to do something different, you know? It's time to change it up and do whatever. But keeping the high level of energy and just, like, now we're just kind of getting more of, like, a brainstorming idea of just, you know, more LED panels, more lighting, more, you know, like, CO2 and, like, lasers, you know? That's another big thing I need to talk to, like, JDS with it, though. But it's just trying to evolve it to, like, its own thing just for San Antonio, you know, like
that's amazing. And you know what I was thinking about too right now as you're talking about this is that everyone does some type of big event.
All four of y'all,
you know, that's a huge thing because you're bringing San Antonio together. So you have Josh Davies Entertainment, boxing, music. You know, talk about that.
Really quick before we get to that. Okay, I'm sorry. I do apologize. But I did want to just say, because I know we had you talking about Silent Disco and it was my first time ever going. I don't think we got to really talk about it. It was our first time there, and I had a fucking blast. Like we were in there fucking lit.
Nat called me 1,000 times though, and I'm not gonna say any names. She's like, get home.
No, but Nat was like, Nat literally was like, what do I do with these?
It was the first time.
Like, put them on, girl. Damn.
I didn't understand the whole concept.
You know why I love the Silent Disco is because he is able to put all the local DJs, and that's key thing is the local DJs coming together, no Eagles aside, for this event.
MCs, yes, exactly. And you know what though?
So like, Child.
So there was one year though, like I did, I was like, oh, let's think bigger, right? But I kind of like took it the other way when I should have just kept on going, you know, like the way that I've always thought of it. Like it's a day for us DJs to be us, you know, no handcuffs. If you want to drop a country set, drop a goddamn country set. You know,
two-stepping.
I mean, whatever you feel in the mood to do. I had some dude dropping a reggae. I had another dude just doing just straight 90s. And like, yo, that's the day for you. You know what I mean? So that we're gonna keep that same mentality but just grow.
Ask.
Where do I host it at?
We do it at Shenanigans. Yes, Shenanigans.
Number two, right?
Yeah, number two off of 151 and Petrenko.
Yeah.
So yes. Yeah.
R.I.P. to Steven. R.I.P. to
Steven. Yes. Yes.
Do you have a date set for this year yet?
Yes, September 7th.
Ooh. September 7th,
yes. Labor Day weekend.
Different venue?
No, we're going to keep it there because they've been so great with us, but we're going to extend the fencing and the parking lot.
Okay.
So, because we were tight, right?
Yeah,
we were tight
up in that thing.
No, but we had a lot of room, but it just got. Yo, barely tied in.
They got Shaquille O'Neal as a bodyguard. That dude was hating big time. In that
we call him Diesel.
Have y'all been to the Silent Disco?
No.
I've never been.
It's a little bit different.
So now that all of y'all are here, we gotta make sure everyone supports one another.
That's good.
That sounds like a good idea. Royal Slay, maybe we'll throw a little VIP over there.
Yes, I would love that. That would be amazing.
That would be crazy. Y'all up in there.
So we got a long while, though. September 7th, so we got a lot of time, but, you know, brand new year, new ideas. I know you guys have all y'all crazy ideas for y'all's events coming up too. So
Josh,
I think everybody's excited.
What do we have coming up with you, man? Davies Entertainment.
We're still planning out the year, but everything's just happening like real fast, and it's crazy because we just signed another boxer last year.
Congratulations!
Appreciate it.
What's up?
Yeah,
last year meaning like last week.
I mean last week, yeah, basically.
Hey, still last year.
So Donald Reed. Shout out to Donald Reed. But we've also got the music division with Vision and Bankroll. I mean, we've done work with him, so it's pretty cool to see you know, people in the city coming together and doing different things with each other, because I never knew I'd be working with him, but I mean, you know, our artists were on, you know, part of his event and stuff like that, so it's pretty cool. But yeah, everything, Davies Entertainment is just moving really fast, and we're trying to keep up. We just signed a big contract for James Kirkland, who's one of our pros.
There we go.
So he'll be on one of the big... either Fox Sports or ESPN in the coming months. So we can't say too much, but yeah, it's pretty cool because Davies Entertainment will be everywhere.
We won't tell nobody.
I can't.
Yeah, that's what's up,
man. I can't. I want to, but I can't.
It's like the Krabby Patty recipe, something like that, right?
Yeah.
Hey, hold up. Hey, give me some love, though. How about them Cowboys? Oh, shit. You see how I did that?
How about the Patriots?
We're going to win. I knew it. I had to throw that out there, man.
That backfired, bro.
Mel went quiet on social media. He disappeared for a bit.
He did disappear.
Melvin, you just got a haircut. Relax.
I know.
Damn.
That's what I'm talking about.
Look at the shots fired.
You see how they be acting, bro? You give them a little love on the internet show. They start, that's it.
I wouldn't even know if you were quiet on Facebook because I'm blocked.
My girls, they'll come for you.
I know. I like them, man. Shout out to Royal Slay, man. Leave me a boy alone, man.
You'll be on the page tomorrow, so be careful.
Should be before, after.
Hey, man, it's all good, man. The Cowboys got a new coach. Good luck with that, man. We'll see what happens.
I mean, it's not who we wanted or who I wanted, but we'll see what happens.
Hey. You happy with it?
Happy with it.
Oh, thank you for that money.
So we have a Cowboys fan. Cowboys fan.
Cowboys. Giants right
I'm
here.
I'm a Giants fan. Yeah.
Giants
I'm
fan.
A Giants fan.
Don't watch baseball. So I
baseball. Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh,
football.
Hell no. Whoa. Hell no. How's she trying to clown somebody? Oh. She watching the wrong sport.
Football, that's but okay.
What just
get
happened?
Get in my asshole, Ethan Wells.
See what I'm saying?
So you got Patriots, Cowboys.
No, I'm not a fan of any NFL team, but I
do. No, this is what she does. No. She'll watch any sport that we watch. She'll find the cutest guy, and that's the team that goes for. That's what she does.
There we have it.
Okay, some of it's that.
She's in love with Kuzma. So she's a Lakers fan one day, and then
whatever my people go for, I go for them at the time. I went for the Seahawks yesterday because of JT.
What about the audience? What is some of y'all's teams?
You can't be a bad
Cowboys. Do we have Cowboys?
Don't.
Yes, Cowboys. Cowboys.
I'm a basketball girl. I'm all about basketball.
We got a Saints fan right there. Saints fan.
Saints fan.
Saints?
Where? Who?
There you go. Saints. That's what's
Charger,
up.
Charger, triple.
Damn.
A Saints fan. Wow.
All right. Get into my man right here.
Alan.
How y'all doing, everybody? Hey, good stuff.
What up, though?
JDS. That's what I was asking about the... where you have it at, because AV Expression, like we have a warehouse downtown in Southtown. Yeah. And I don't know, you heard of AV Expression?
Yeah.
So
I see it always popping up and stuff, so stuff. I'm like, cool.
Yeah, I was just wondering, it's a good stuff. Good
networking is key.
Underground, yeah.
It is a key.
And that's what I was picturing, like, this would be an amazing opportunity for everybody to kind of like, you know, from different places and different energies, kind of have
Alan was able
to
bring
more.
In the, no, wait.
The weed?
Manifest.
I thought he said the weed. So, he said the herb. Oh, that nigga brought the weed, man. We live. We're good
to go.
We got those too.
Right.
I was trying to remember the name.
I have been not smoking to nothing. Yeah.
Urban, watching the Urban Music Festival.
And that's kind of similar to what Tone does with the DJs, but with the local artists
now. That's perfect. And we were actually thinking about creating something for DJs as well. But now that you have that, it's like we should help you do that, help that.
Oh yeah, no, I mean, I think everyone should work together, like, and there's just so many things that people try to, like, I don't want to say do things on their own versus, it's like, hey, like, we are an amazing city.
It's all
and
about
we should
too,
all
right?
Like just bring yes
timing.
Exactly too though, but we should all like
eventually,
collab together. Of course,
I know about a lot of folks here and some people I don't know about, but I know that obviously we're here for a reason, and we're all going probably towards the same goals for ourselves. So kind of going back to, what we're doing this year, he was talking about, figuring out how to do it bigger and better, how to take it to the next level. That's the same energy. I got homie PU here with me. He's for it. He's another platform in San Antonio.
All right.
Dope.
An amazing platform. So, of course, I want to thank him for all his support and bringing energy behind me to continue to keep growing. Soul Child, everybody around here. So, you got to give energy and shout outs to everybody that's helping and doing stuff. So,
they said you got to shout La Raza.
What?
La Raza.
La Raza.
Yeah.
West Side, South Side, we out there, baby.
Now, yeah. I do want to say I was able to go to Manifest, and it was dope. It was a dope event. It was cool to see all the local artists kind of, come out and show out, and I got introduced to some other artists I'd never heard of in my life that were actually really dope. We had one of Davies Entertainment on Bankroll. He fucking killed it.
Yeah, we're excited for Bankroll. Shout out to Davies. They come in here a powerhouse.
Yeah.
Just damn near taking over all kinds of stuff. So
it's kind of mobbing
excited.
There.
Yeah,
I'm super excited to have you on the city. I connected with Question. We got Bankroll. We're trying to get Vision. He just dropped his project, so we're like, let's get Vision on. And we want to help, like I said in the beginning, help as many artists as possible. But at first, the people that are helping themselves the most, we want to help those people most, because they're putting in all the heavy work, and everyone deserves an opportunity. But
amen to that. Everyone does, and it's great to have you guys come on the show and be able to share what y'all have going on. Because of the fact that we want this platform to be something for other promoters, other bar owners, other event organizers, and to see like, hey, we could come on this show, get the views, get the numbers, and get the exposure and the proper promotions. Because if you think about it, Kins, KSAT, what else, Fox, they all have daytime shows. They all have a daytime show, morning show. But there's no one that actually has a local night show that talks about the positive things that the nightlife entertainment promotion brings. And so we have Late Nights with All Access, to where we want to be that platform. We want to be that to go to where people can say, hey, you know what? I want to be on the show. We see that you put your promotions aside. You know, I have All Access Promotion Entertainment, but this is not all about All Access. This is about you guys, you viewers. And that's the team that's what we want to bring in. And so to see like-minded people, like, damn, it's going to be beautiful.
It feels good, right?
It feels good. It does. Now you have
me siento muy excited.
I don't know what you just said. Okay. I know a little bit what you said. Damn,
about. Busting out of Spanish here and there. Goddamn, ask me.
That's a Selena quote, by the way.
You had an event that we attended, and it was the Halloween bash.
I did. Now,
hey, that shit lit, though.
Yeah, do you have other, you know, events that you want to do, or other events that you want to be part of, now that you're hearing kind of our...
I don't know. So what's up? Imagine. No, yes. No, I do actually. For 2020, ready, like ready? You said, I don't have everything planned out.
Okay.
So far, what I do have dropping soon is my first makeup palette.
Congratulations on that.
So I'm very excited about that.
There you go.
So, yes, that will be coming out in March. And I'm very excited, nervous, because it's my first one. And it will be with Perspective Fiends, which I already collaborate with them. And they are magnificent. I have lashes with them. So I've been working with them for about 2 years. So that's where my eyeshadow palette will come from. Then after that, I am looking forward to do another pop-up shop, which I was the very first one to do it in San Antonio. And I'm so appalled. And I want to thank everybody for going. Toy is the first one that came to me. And he was like, you know what? You should do this. And I was like, you're right. That's why you're number one San Antonio promoter. So, yeah. So from that, and then from three of them. And see, that's that coming together. That's what it's about. San Antonio, we're just trying to make it.
Facts.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
it's happening.
Yep.
Yeah, we talked about that on our podcast. Shout out to Midnight Society.
Hey.
But, like, there's always people trying to do things in the city, and there's a few out there that try to do it by themselves and go against everybody, but it's not going to happen. It's not going to work like that. You can't. So, I mean, there's so many, you know, talented people in the city that you're going to find somebody that has what you need, and then y'all collab and create something, you know, great. So... a lot of people in this building I've worked with for years. I've known for, I don't know, 15, 20 years. So it's crazy to see how we all started, where we started, but we've all collabed in one way or another, and we'll continue to do it. And we need to do it because that's what's going to put San Antonio on the map.
Yeah, you know what? It's crazy. It's a great feeling to know that. And one of the goals that we want to do is, and I think we are. Going to start a closed group page to where it says we support all promotions, and anybody that wants to be talking about, if you're a promotional team or organizer, event organizer, the closed group page is going to be we support all promotions, to where I'm talking about, I want all the promoters, I want every single buddy that if you're off on Monday night, I want you all to agree that we're going to go on a Monday night to support this person. And if it's all the same, like, you know what I mean, like, unified everyone to where, hey, we can keep these local bars alive, we could keep these local promoters ongoing, you know, because that's what it used to be. Like, for me, when I got in the game, John Vail, shout out to John Vail, he was one of our special guests from 2019, and he told me, he goes, you promote for me Tuesday, Wednesday, but I need you to go out Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and I need you to go out to all these places to bring them back here Tuesday. I was like, what? He's like, yep. He's like, that's the only way you're going to be able to do it. He goes, you go out, show love, tell them to come back to my bar, and then that's how we're going to start. And I think that's what people need to do now, is put their egos aside and come together. We all support, you know, promotions, and go from every single night.
And, you know, especially right now, because we are in this month, and I think everybody in here knows about January.
Oh, yeah.
January just goes what?
It's the bottom.
Just like, everybody spent their money on Christmas, New Year's. They paid their rent. I mean, I'm pretty sure right at midnight, you know, That thing just got deducted to pay your mortgage or house rent or whatever. You're like, oh man, like, you know what I mean? Like 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, you know. So, but again, like January though, is this one of those months that like, man, it's an amazing idea that this is right now. We should all be trying to be doing this right now, you know, and because it's just one of those slow months. And imagine, you know, by the time when they get that income tax money.
I know, February, they're all ballers.
Everybody's balling all ballers. Out. They're going to spend all that
when
thing.
I get the income tax, I'm trying to go to Whataburger.
Whataburger, that girl, huh? All right, nothing wrong with that.
So now we do have Justin. Justin's in the audience, and he has a microphone to where the audience, whoever who wants to do some Q&As right now, too, as well. If you have a question.
Ooh, not too personal.
I think. Jacob over here is putting his hand up. I can't see who he's pointing to. David D. So
D
anybody
one?
That wants to ask a question right now,
anybody,
free.
My Rose Lake girls, anybody,
so
anybody?
Go ahead right now. Let's see. Okay, there. we got over here. Say your name and who you want to ask a question to. Again, viewers, please continue to watch. We're doing this live audience broadcast, and I think we could get a second view on there. Steven, our producer, try to get that second view, please, so that we can see. What? Let's see if we can do it. If not, go ahead. What's your name?
My name is Monica.
Monica, okay.
And this question is for Esme.
Esme, all right.
Esme!
So I know you've been doing the page for a little while. Well, a while. What was, when you first started, what was your, I guess, like, vision? Did you think it was going to get this big compared to when you started to now? Like, how do you see it?
Honestly, I didn't think I was going to come this far. I honestly did it for fun. And then from there, it just progressed. And I started getting like messages as far as like, oh, can you do this? And I was like, oh, what's going on? I was just going live just for fun, doing my hair, my makeup. And then I had some people that I was talking to, and I put two and two together. And I was like, I'm gonna make something out of this. And here we are now.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good question. Good question, thank you. Okay, anybody else wanna ask a question? Anyway, y'all better raise your hands and ask a question.
Start singing this.
Come on now.
I don't have
Come
a question, but
go.
I have a
there
comment
go.
While
Clifton
we're waiting
right
for
there.
Somebody.
Clifton
I just
right
want, I do want to commend Esme because I have known her since SA Night Live days. For those of y'all that remember us from SA Night Live days, it was a long ass time ago. But I do want to commend you for, you know, you've come a long way since then. So I just wanted to give you a shout out.
You and me
I
both,
watch
friend.
The episode. I do want to give you a shout out and show my respect.
Thank you.
You over
appreciate
here
it.
Doing
you and me
a
both.
Big thing in the city, and it's just. You know, it's been cool to see you then and now and shit. So,
hell
thank
yeah.
Shout out to you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Doing a thing in the city.
Yes.
Shout out to SA Night Live, Angel. Thank you for putting us together.
Damn, they over here getting on you. They over here, Chris.
All right, so we have.
Hi, my name is Clifton Simmons.
Oh, that's Cliff.
Cliff. There we go.
All right, my question's for DJ Tone. What has been one of your crazy experiences as a DJ?
Oh, shit.
Girlfriend's in the house. Girlfriend's in the house.
Yo, chill. right.
This was kind of funny, actually.
Okay, let's go.
This is the one without. I'm not involved in it.
No. All right, cool. So, it was weird. It was man. How long ago was this? Maybe like
it was a dark night.
3, 4.
It's a dark night.
You thinking of the
fog?
Inside Taboo.
No, not that one. No, no.
No, not
no,
that
no, no, no. This is
that was that foggy
no,
night.
No, 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 not that. Now this is something even funnier, crazier, whatever. So, I do a lot of stuff with Aztec Live Nation, and so there was an event that they were doing that they were showing up late, or I could just say it was Chief Keef, and they were held up for a while, like I think in the I think they're in a border town or something like that, and they're like. We need some music right now. Like, you know, they're like 3 hours late. I was like, shit. All right, cool. I was like, do me a favor, just dim the lights, you know, just be cool. I'm just gonna be like, just plain, just real, just don't turn up the music or nothing. Like, just keep it cool. And then all of a sudden, like, the first act shows up first, like the first tour bus or whatever, and then. I'm like, all right, cool, you're here. Damn, I was DJing for like felt like forever, you know, because it just the time was just going forever. Anywho, let me just keep going. They were just like, they were angry already. The crowd was just fucking pissed, like mad or whatever. And as soon as the DJ gets on, boo, boo, I'm like, oh shit, because he just like turned it on like crazy or whatever, right? And then the first act comes on, boo, boo. I'm like, oh dude, like, what are you?
Turn it off.
I'm like. Like, I'm in the back just, like, watching. I'm like, shit, that could have been me. Like, fuck. Like, and then the second act goes on. Boo! Boo! I'm like, oh, my God, dude. Like, what is going on? Like, this is just, like, a disaster. Like, ready to get. There was just no way of winning, though. Like, that night that I learned, like, something of the craziest of the craziest. I learned something that night. Even if you try, like, whatever, like, sometimes you're just not gonna win. Like, and I saw those guys, those DJs and those artists, they were really trying to make up for like that time that they were late. And I was like, fuck, like that could just happen to anybody. Like just on the real, you know? But I was just like, oh, I'm glad I'm about to leave right now. But that was like, that was pretty crazy though. That was pretty crazy though.
I was gonna say, nobody knows like what actually happens behind the scenes.
Right.
So all they know is that the guy's late and like it's their fault that, you know, but.
Dude, they're antsy. They were just there just antsy. Yeah. And I was just like, mm.
I have
like,
a question for you, Alan. Would you consider doing a teen music festival? Because we thought about it more, and I was like, man, I wonder if he ever thought about just doing a teen music festival, you know?
Yeah, so. I think I brought that up to Homie P about creating, I mean, and now we'll put it out there, and maybe we can, now it's being created, and maybe now we can create a platform for it. Creating like a showcase for high schoolers, pretty much, you know, any high school up and rising or any aspiring artists that want to become artists, creating a platform and a showcase to where they can come and we can put a great production behind them, put them on a good platform and pretty much find the next rising talented artist coming out of San Antonio before, you know, they even graduate high school. So definitely we've thought about that and considered that, and I think that's actually in our plans. So
all right, there you go,
dude. That needs to happen though. Remember back like the high school time, like when we actually had like those dope high school parties, like
high school party in the club.
Man, that was like
dang. Yes. I wouldn't even know because my dad was so strict.
Shout out Scott.
You missed out.
Scott Maloof,
you missed out.
That's where a lot of us met though. That's what's 16. Crazy is
hell yeah,
high school parties.
Yes, yeah, so
wearing different colored shirts.
That's a good question, and thank you for almost creating, helping us create that. You know, it's almost, it feels like it needs to
I
be.
I just want 5%, and that's it.
We have the platform for it, so we should do a little something like that, and so it'll come. Thank you.
Again, okay, viewers, you continue to watch us. We're gonna take our first break, but
hold
we
on,
want
before break.
Oh, wait, before break. Go ahead, go ahead.
Social medias, really quick.
Social medias, go ahead.
Get them out, guys. Tone? You can hit me up at DJTone_180 or DJToneNightlife.com.
I'm pretty much the tatted genius on everything. You can find me on Facebook, Joshua Davies.
Mind and soul music. Mind and soul. Everyone has a mind. Everyone has a soul.
Oh, I like that. Music. Do y'all want my TikTok or WhatsApp? Imagine.
Girl, I've been seeing those videos. I've been seeing those videos.
No, it's going to be as me.
I ain't going to say nothing. I'm going to leave it alone.
Yeah. That's going to be Esme Idalise with 3 S's for Instagram. And then Royal Slay is Esme Leia.
And before y'all get off, who are your top 5 DJs? So that everyone. Nope.
I'm not doing that shit again.
Let's go. Just go. Come on, like top of the head. Top 5, come on.
Hey, it could be you. It could be you.
You can't name yourself, Tone.
In the city? He can. I'm my own supporter.
You can name yourself, man. You play, man.
No, like in the city or just like in general?
I think we're screwed if we don't say Tone.
In the city.
Plus
Tsunami.
Come on, hurry up.
Shit.
Come on.
We're going for a short break.
All right. Obviously, Donnie D is like the man.
There you go, Donnie D.
Legend.
I love M3. He's freaking dope. God, you just put me on the spot.
Yeah, I did.
I'm just thinking of just different categories. Man, you know, when I'm going to work, sometimes though, Cobweb is already DJing already, okay. And I love that energy every single time right before I'm driving to work because he starts to.
That's 3. Come on.
Shut up.
That boy Joshua about to get in trouble.
I already know it.
All right, Josh, go ahead. Come on.
Yeah, that boy about to get in trouble.
Come on, well, come on.
I know there's a few DJs in here right now, but it says, like, no disrespect to y'all. But no, Donnie D, obviously, Double R. Yes, Nat Boogie, if she starts fucking DJing again.
Yeah. I will, Nat Boogie.
Yeah. There we go. Yes.
I've said D1, C1. I mean, there's a lot of them. So, okay. But
Alan?
Yeah, it's hard. AOK, my own DJ, A-Town.
Okay.
We got our own label DJ. Who else is there? DJ Fat, DJ Young Key. They're doing a great job out in the night scene. And I can't fill in the last two.
Okay, Esme?
Pauly D, Imagine. No. Okay, you already know my first one. DJ Mystic, won. Congratulations to you, baby dad. Number two will
down,
be
baby.
DJ Free. DJ Free. And then I got to go with DJ Drew, because I've known him for a long time.
Yeah,
and then Richie Rich.
Yeah.
And then DJ Tonic.
All right. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Our first guest right here on our live audience broadcast.
Thank y'all. Congratulations.
Thank you guys.
Muchas gracias. Congratulations. Mike,
thank
Melvin.
Y'all
are doing good for everybody. Yeah. Too,
so. Nat.
One year. Yeah.
Cheers,
Matt. I mean, you started a lot for the city because y'all are showcasing.
Started from the bottom. Now we're here.
Just keep them moving. Yeah, just keep them moving. And you know what? Hey, just right before we cut it off, though, I love how you guys are really just bringing it all together, because you all know that there has been a lot of negative energy, like in this scene, and I feel that you guys are just like pulling them together, and
y'all
you
good
know,
team.
Just
y'all
good energy. So thank you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right. So shout out to y'all. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Thank you guys.
I'm going somewhere.
Awesome.
I have to
pee. Thank you.
Tipo de público, tortillas deliciosas hechas a mano, es una maravilla, realmente muy recomendable.
Gracias, vida mía. It was delicious, it was warm, it was amazing, great service, and we just want to thank you for making our team building event amazing. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for continuing to watch Late Nights with All Access. We're right now back. We have Esme still on stage with us.
That's right, that's right.
Royal Slay. And you know what? One of the reasons why is because she was the most viewed episode in 2019. I wonder if anyone's going to break their record in 2020. Maybe not. Maybe. You never know. But right now, as a commercial break, you're able to see some new footages and new promo videos. I'm probably going to say this name wrong, Steven. Fu in Chinese? Pho in Chinese. Vita Mia Mexican Cuisine. The Bread Box. Barbecutie. Shout out to Maurice and Tom. Barbecutie, they also are owners of Costa Pacifica. If you haven't been to Costa, gotta go out there. Love the food over there. But Barbecutie is actually good food too as well. And then you have Sarita's Mexican Restaurant. So again, those are our promo videos that we're sharing right now during our commercial break. So again, thank you to all of you guys. Now, coming right back on, first set was amazing to see every single buddy on here.
That's right.
It was fun, man.
You know, it is
fun. I enjoyed that.
A lot of good vibes, man. A lot of good vibes.
So now we're going to go ahead and bring in our second set of a special guest coming back onto the show. So first one that we're going to go ahead and bring up to the stage is going to be Soul Child Jordan. Soul Child Jordan, come on up to the stage, baby.
Soy el público.
Really?
With the shot and everything.
Okay.
Dang.
That's how
you do it. Soul Child Jordan.
Mic check, yes. I was at the bar right now. I thought we were taking a break. But
then we have our first special guest that was on our broadcast, Scott Maloof.
Scott Maloof.
The legend, the GOAT.
Hey.
You know, he's helped out and promoted for pretty much everyone in the city.
I gotta play something because...
In the real estate Neo. Game.
Look at that swag.
Man, my boy Scott Maloof, baby.
I was like, I love your hat. I was like, bro.
I like it.
Again, he was our first special guest from 2019. Called him up and said, "Hey, Scott, would you mind coming on and being our special guest? This is something that I had envisioned." And he said, "You don't have to say anymore." He's like, "I got you."
It's all love.
It's all love right there, you know. So again, you have Scott Maloof, you have Soul Child Jordan,
what's up,
Esme, and we're right back again.
Right back at it. Right back at it again.
So how's it, man, Jordan? What's some things that you have coming up for this year?
Well, this year's, I mean, I don't know if I can top last year. Last year was incredible. I mean, literally from the beginning to the end of the last weekend of 2019, I was booked consistently, whether it was a show, a concert, a fashion show, a barber battle, you know, DJing at Sugar's or, you know, hosting a wedding or quinceañera or doing a special guest or, you know, it was definitely packed. So it's definitely going to be hard. All phones on silent. It's definitely gonna be hard to top it. I mean, but you know, like they were saying earlier. I mean, every year, my boy Alan. Every year, I definitely set the goal of topping myself, no matter what it is. And you know, when I first moved here to San Antonio, you know, I had set goals for myself, and once I reached those, I set more goals, and I reached those, and things that I never thought I was gonna be doing. You know, I kind of already did, you know, so it's kind of hard to top that. But, you know, every year I feel like we get a little older and we want a little bit more for ourselves, you know, and then we watch the next generation of people come, you know. So I definitely want to keep doing what I'm doing, but in a definitely more mature way, you know what I mean? And still, you know, whether it be in front of the scenes or behind the scenes, I mean, there's plenty of money to be made, you know what I mean? So I'm just very grateful for as far as I've gotten. And, you know, I'm just excited to see what happens next year. I haven't set any hardcore goals. I'm just, you know, just going with the flow. Yeah.
All right. Now, Scott Maloof.
What's going on?
I see you.
Sell me a house.
I got you.
Teach me your ways.
Anyone looking to buy, sell, invest, reach out to
us. Straight to the point right there.
Royals ladies. That's the guy right there.
Appreciate it. That's always love. I know he has me for a long time. So, actually, I know him. all y'all for a long time. So.
That's right. That's right.
Now, Scott, what are some big things that you have coming up? What are your goals? I mean, what did y'all finish off in 2019? Share with the viewers and everyone. Like, how many houses were combined?
So our team, we ended up closing out 370 properties in 2019.
Damn! Right there, yeah. Round of applause right there.
That's that grow money.
That is goal.
That's a goal. That's an accomplishment.
And what's your goal this year?
Our goal this year is 500 properties.
Double
that. So 500 properties this year. Our five-year goal is 5% market share in San Antonio, which is 3,672 homes in 1 year.
Goodness.
And we'll get it.
And who could get it? You can get it.
We're going to get it.
Yeah, no, he can. If anything, Scott.
I always told people that I said, you know what? There's one promoter that I believe that if you called, like say the promotion was Friday night and Thursday night, you needed to pack it out. I always tell people, call Scott Maloof.
Maloof
Entertainment. He'll pack that in one night. That's it. He doesn't need a two-week promotion. Do it the night before.
Right. And if anything, Scott is a big influence. I mean, when I saw Scott, you know, I moved here when I was 23. I didn't know a single person. But, I mean, from moving to promoter, he definitely set the example to where, you know, if you're not buying a club or, you know, running a club by the time you're 30-something and you're still a promoter, you know, you definitely gotta reevaluate. And if anything that Scott done is set the example to where, all right, you can be the promoter, you can be the number one in the city, you know, and then take that and switch it into a grown and, you know, more responsible job. I mean, he moved it into the realtor. He took all his followers with him, you know what I mean? So then he takes all the people who also, you know, want to be just like him or be up and coming or get into realty. And, you know, I don't know if this is too much, but I mean, I've heard that, you know, he'll pay for, you know, certain people's classes to get them, you know, moved on and into involved, you know, into his group and you know, team. And it's definitely, you know, definitely set the example of where, you know, where to go to where once you're a promoter and you're making that money and then you take that next step.
He's a godfather. He's a godfather.
He tells you exactly how to do it is what I mean.
Es el padrino.
Yeah, you have some people in the comments saying, Maloof, are you single?
Don't answer that right here because we lie, Scott. We lie.
I'm single.
Oh, he's single.
He said it.
And that's not my focus, though. My focus is, you know, where we're growing. You know, the team. I look at life as seasons, and where we are today is a new season. And everybody that's in my world, they've gone through a different season. And sometimes, you know, people, they go through rough patches in life. And we figure out, we never look down on people unless we're helping them up. And, you know, we have that conversation all the time on
I like that.
Where are we growing and what's it look like 1 year, 5 years, and then what are the action steps going to take to be able to get you there? So, I you know, the club, we learned a lot in there, and that was a stepping stool to get me where I am today. I see AJ's watching too. Shout out AJ Hearns.
What's up, Hearns?
His birthday coming up, so that's my brother too. So as far as where we're at today and where the people are that in my life, I know that they all have their own goals, and we're just trying to continue to be better people in life. That's just point blank period. That's where we're at.
Scott, one of my real estate girls want to know, what's your skincare routine? Because you don't age.
Yo, Vita Valdez says, I just want to know his skincare routine because this dude doesn't age.
So I'm Lebanese. So it's in the blood. The Lebanese. Y'all learn.
Shout out to Jody Joe.
You got the beard growing out now.
I am growing the beard. So this is new. The facial hair, this is something I'm intending to see how it works out. Makes me look a little bit older.
They said single or single? Like.
Single.
Valentine's Day is coming up, so he's single.
Now, Scott, you being, what made you make that transition from promoting into real estate? Like, why did you completely stop the promotions?
So, the word D-side stands for death of all of the options. So, when you decide to do something, there's no, like, pesticide or suicide. Decide, death of all of the options. So when I decided that I was going to be going into a new career, I couldn't be out in the club till 2 a.m. drinking, because 2 a.m. usually turns into 3:30. And then waking up the next day, I would not be at 100%. So for me to be able to say, you know, completely say this is going to be my career, I had to let go of my past. And it's not that I don't enjoy, you know, I love going out. It's just I had to make a decision on where I saw myself 5-10 years from now, and I didn't intend to see myself at Mama Margie's at 3:30 a.m. figuring out what's going on.
And nothing wrong with Mama Margie's tacos, by the way. There's chips and salsa.
Oh, we've put a lot of money in Mama Margie's.
Kept them open. I would say with Scott Maloof dealing with the stuff that I was dealing with, Scott Maloof was actually a person that sent an Uber to my house, pick me up, and go to the hookah lounge, which I like to do. And we sat down and had the most dopest conversation. And he is actually one of the main reasons why I'm not in that stage anymore. Scott was telling me you can either be bitter or better. The only difference is the eye, you know what I'm saying? So, and then we had other conversations on the 5-year plan, 6-year plan, and more and more and more. And I would like to thank Scott Maloof for that right there, because that helped me get out of the situation, which led to the haircut, which led to other things like
that. Fresh cut right there, baby. Thank you, Scott. Yes, thank you, Scott. Yeah, I was talking about finest. Come on, you got to do something with it. Yeah, you're not Mel Ugly. You Mel Finest. Come on now. Come on now.
He just got a haircut. And you said it was free. You blessed.
That's what I said too.
No, I'm telling you, Soul Child inboxed me. Said, "About damn time."
I said,
"Bro,
you gotta get that fresh air. If there's one thing about me, no matter how depressed I am, a haircut will always make me feel 10 times better.
Yeah,
a haircut will always make me feel 10 times better."
I'm gonna tell you, no bullshit.
Shout out to Randy, the barber.
Randy's the shit. So the barbershop literally opened up early so I can get a haircut. A lot of barbers were there. Everybody saying, "God damn, Melvin, it's about time you got a haircut," because we were worried really bad about you.
So I want to know if they did this. They scratched their hand. They were like, "Come in. Come in.
Now, a lot of people were, you know, I would say thank all of you guys. People that reached out to me, doesn't matter where we are at. And
loved y'all too.
Yeah, thank you. Mike Anthony, I would tell you, I'm going to keep it real. Mike Anthony helped me out big time. A lot of people on the stage helped me out. Doesn't matter if it was just a quick text, inbox, or yo, you good, all that. Thank all of you guys very much, because I wouldn't be. And sometimes all you need is just like, "Yo, you good?" And thank all of you for real, because that really meant a lot to me. And thank you guys, all of you.
It's always good to have supporters and people that care and love, you know. And to see the growth that everyone's on here with the stage. I mean, Scott, you influence a lot of people in the city that want to become a realtor or just want to get in the game of promotions, you know. And I like how you said that about deciding out of the promotions, because a lot of the times I look at myself and I've seen you, I've seen a special guest, a toy, which he's going to be up here next, exit your way out of the promotions. And I've thought about that for myself, to where do I want to promote any more or any longer? And I like it though, you know, it's so crazy. I like it so much to where you network with a lot of people that you're able to meet that you probably wouldn't have met.
Really quick. I'm sorry. I don't mean to
interrupt. Go ahead.
Yo, they're going off in the comments.
It's my fucking brother's birthday. Where the fuck is Joshua?
Happy birthday, Josh. Happy birthday.
What time is it? Is it midnight right now?
It's Mel's mom's birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to my mama. Happy birthday to my mama.
I know she's watching. Happy birthday.
Anybody that's born on a 6 is great to me.
I just had to give him a real quick. There he is.
Happy birthday.
Josh.
What's in your cup? What is that?
Happy 33rd. Getting old and shit. You are not about to take a four horseman.
It looks like the roommate is taking care of you tonight, right? The roommate is taking care of you tonight.
You gotta take it all live. It's your birthday. Come up here and take it real quick.
That's our brother and sister love.
Can we say happy birthday real quick?
Yes, we can say happy birthday.
In Spanish or what? English?
Everybody drop a hashtag happy birthday for Josh.
Happy birthday to you.
Cha cha cha.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh, he was looking for you to sing the harmony. She was looking for you to sing the harmony.
Happy birthday to you.
There you go.
Mesa
que más aplauda, sí. Mesa que más aplauda, no.
Was that really a four horseman?
Yes.
Fuck my
life. It smelled like one.
Happy birthday right there. Once again, happy birthday to Josh.
Happy birthday. Love you. We're definitely partying. It definitely smelled like one. So please stay after for the party, because it's about to be lit.
continue, you know. Now, I know that we have 2020, and I want to know from both of you guys, what are some big things to where, like, events wise, like, that you want to see, or what events do you part of? Is there any events that you're part of this year, coming up this year, that you can discuss?
Scott, you know what? The events that you put on now, I heard your Christmas party was insane.
Your Christmas party.
Well, that was it. We actually
okay.
had
it. Yeah. I was like, I want to go to the Christmas party. That's what I did. I was going to be like, I'm a realtor for some realty.
He put his overall up.
So I could get in, because that Christmas party was like exclusive.
It was lit.
So that's the events that he's putting on.
Esme was having a party in the basement.
No, he came to my party. He came to my party. I had the party.
I think that was a smart move from Adrian.
Shout out to the smoke restaurant.
Shout out to Adrian.
That is the number one spot to throw your Christmas event. And smoke restaurant. Barbecue. That's where it's at.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Bro, I think they had like a whole like accident outside. The windows broke and everything. And they said, we still got the parties going on.
We was waiting for you at the dope.
As far as events on my side, so I've left a lot of the nightlife and all that, and I do have plans on doing bigger concerts and bigger events. So
there we go.
One of my goals is to bring Boys to Men down. There's certain comedians.
Boys to Men.
Boys to Men.
So there's a lot of certain events that I intend to do coming up.
Mountain.
Hey, you know what? We need to talk, because I want to do
Some
events
too.
I want to bring
in my manager.
Well, I want to bring in some of the 90s and early 2000 people. That would be pretty cool.
This is live.
Bring in like the 90s and the early 2000s, some of the artists all together.
Hip hop, 90s.
It would be.
Right. That's what, when I walk in the office, I say, Alexa, play 1990s R&B. Everyone in
Alexa, 1990.
What's your favorite song, R&B?
From 90s. Boys to Men, End of the Road. I mean,
End of the Road, there you
go. With Boys to Men.
Boys to Men.
Everything 90s.
For R&B, Boys to Men.
Drew Hill.
What about you?
Everything. Drew Hill, bro, I'm more like a little bit more R&B, so like Drew Hill, Brandy, like sitting in my room, like,
so
you know
Drew
what I'm saying?
Drew Hill, okay, we're sticking with that. And then you, R&B?
I'm more like hip hop throwback.
I'm a 90s baby for sure. I remember watching New York Undercover.
I like everything.
Like listening to TGIF, doing like the Nights at Showtime at Apollo. Like 90s baby, you can't top it. Snake on Saturdays. Like 90s, baby, for sure.
Now
always.
Back to the real question. You two, because you already answered top five favorite DJs in the city.
Oh, I already did. If you tune into my episode, you'll see who's on my top five. So I don't have to say it today, right? It's his turn.
I already said mine. DJ
Vistay. You didn't say yours today.
I did.
No, you
did
not
you?
Today.
Not today.
I got to say my list again.
You got to say it again. Yeah.
Say it again.
Well, since I already did, that means Scott has to go first, so I could think.
Scott can go first.
All right. Well, my number one, hands down, is DJ A-OK.
Ace over Curbane.
A-OK.
A-OK. What is it?
A-OK Curbane.
A-OK Curbane. Is that what
Yeah, that's
called?
My boy James, man, for sure.
So, A-OK.
Okay.
DJ Mystic.
Hey!
For sure.
Then I would go with Donnie D.
Donnie D.
Nappy. And who am I missing?
That's how many of is that? How many is that?
So many.
That's four. That's four.
Four. So you got one
that's
more.
Four. Double R.
Double R.
No. Don't pick for him.
I know.
I know.
I
like that. We brainstorming. We're gonna make it.
City's dope, but it's not. I don't. It's so many DJs I have relationships with. C1's dope.
For sure.
D1's dope. There's so many DJs that I mess with. It's like.
It's hard, right?
Yeah, it's hard.
They're trying to take you off the top eight on MySpace. That's why.
Yeah,
they're
trying
to get blocked by MySpace.
They're like, hey,
we're gonna take them off MySpace.
They ain't gonna do your Christmas party next year.
I mean, I love all the local DJs.
E-Flat's dope. I mean, there's so many.
E-Flat,
DJs.
Shout out
E-Flat,
E-Flat
was
again.
Dope. I even asked Mike. I said, "Who's DJ?" He said, "E-Flat."
I appreciate you,
Xavier. I mean, there's so many DJs that have been around for so long. I just don't.
DJ.
Okay, we set him
that
off.
That fifth one opened it.
I do.
He laid that open so that he didn't hurt nobody's feelings.
I have to give A-OK a shout out, because we actually went to go see him the other day at Jokesters, me and my brother JT. We went to go see him at Jokesters the other night, so it was good to see him do his thing and shit like that. So shout out to A-OK one time. Yes, he did have another baby. Shout out to him and Millie and Baby Girl
Ocean.
Nirvana.
Hey, shout out to DJ Ocean, too.
DJ Ocean.
Ocean's old school.
Yeah.
Yo, I remember just being a young kid, and it was like, DJ Ocean.
Yeah, we had DJ Ocean.
I was like a young ass.
Bliss.
Little boy.
Hey, shout out to JT's son, Jalen. He just tuned in right now. JT's son tuned in right now. So, Jalen, I see you.
Now, Justin, again, Let's go ahead and try to get some questions from the audience. Participate, people. Ooh. Participate.
Wait, was Jordan getting away from talking about his DJs again?
Oh, did he? Oh, shit.
You just bro, I don't know why. I mean, I'm very forgettable. I'm glad.
I guess we'll let you pass.
No. I'm very forgettable. Say real quick.
That's New York.
Oh.
I recognize it immediately.
Oh, you good.
Soul Child. Say your yes. top five. Come on.
You know, it's hard to pick a top five when you have worked with every single DJ in the city.
Come on, top five.
You know, okay, in no particular order, all right? in no particular order, all right? Fuck. I mean, there's so many DJs that
come
definitely,
on,
I mean,
Soulja.
Fuck.
We know this. We know all the DJs.
Okay,
in the city.
I mean, Scott said a lot of them. I mean, D1, Mystic, C1. I mean, shout out to DJ, shout out to DJ City. Shout out my boy,
that boy made sure.
Okay, Soulja, good. X-rated. You good.
Okay, good. There's so many because I've worked with CRG is one. I've definitely seen him come from an underdog, you know, kind of getting on ragged on by the DJs and like kind of just venturing off and doing his own thing, you know, hooking up with Duano and like, you know, doing the Austin thing.
I think
and doing,
one of the,
bro, those,
the top
I mean, there's definitely DJs. I mean, bro, Duano. I literally went to a hotel not too long ago and I was like chilling in the DJ booth and the security taps me on the shoulder. He doesn't want anybody in the booth tonight. So
what was you
doing? I told
so what
Duano.
Was the next move?
I said, okay, you know what? Duano? I'm going to wait over here. You know, because he invited me out. He was like, yo, come chill with me. Da, da, da. So I'm there because I don't really go to a hotel too long. Because, you know, everybody in the city who's not like a hotel regular already knows if you're going to go to a hotel discotheque, it's going to be like a whole night process. You got to get the cut. You got to cover up your, you know, whatever. You got to get the fit. You got to call whoever you got to call to make sure that you don't got to wait in line. You got to make sure that you're going to, you know, break bread when you get there. You know, it's a whole process if you're going to go to a hotel. You know, it is a process. So when Duan was like, all right, I'm going to come out, you know, whatever. So I'm there and I'm just like, all right, you know, da, 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 da. And, you know, he has a whole intro and his lights and he doesn't want nobody in the booth tonight. Okay. I said, all right, I'm gonna wait over here.
Overall.
But, you know, from the civilian looking in from the outside, it's a great, bro. Duan is definitely one of the top, for sure. He's running that shit. So, shout out to Duano, shout out to CRG.
Someone said Xavier the freaking Rican.
Okay, so Justin, we're going to go right into it. Justin, who's going to ask? Say the name.
I'm going to go by Anonymous.
Ron. All right. What's your question to who it is?
Thanks, Mike Anthony. Appreciate it. My question is for Maloof. So Soul Child said you pay for classes for like you know certain people.
Fuck, that's
said,
what
oh
I
shit.
Said. I hope this is saying too much.
He said,
I'm sorry.
Oh shit.
So check it out. Me and you had a conversation
not
too long ago.
Wait, hold on, quiet.
Me and you had a conversation not too long ago. If that offer's on the table, for sure, you know I'm gonna come work for you. You already know what it is. Oh, happy birthday, Joshua too, by the way.
So I have paid for people in the past, and what I've learned sometimes. You need a little skin in the game before, because I paid for the classes and then they don't take the test.
Yeah.
Or certain things don't happen, they don't pass the test, or they get distracted by something else. So if you take the classes, you pass the test, and then you get the license, I'll reimburse you for the classes. I'll do that.
There you go, that's good. That's fair. Okay, now let's get another question over here.
Jacob,
all right,
seriously?
Jacob, okay, go ahead.
Right. Hey, guys, is this shit on?
Yeah, it's on.
It's on, go ahead.
Not really. Hello? I think the Wi-Fi's down.
Wow. Jacob, anyways. What do you want?
Right, come on, guys. Jacob.
So, the podcast. My favorite question is, being in
my
the
favorite,
industry,
he said?
What? Can y'all hear me or no?
I swear yeah, I heard my favorite.
I can hear you now.
My favorite question.
Y'all hear me now? All right. My favorite question is, what is y'all's go-to food truck in the late night?
That's a good question.
Is that for anyone or
all y'all? From left to right. Let's start from you, Mike. Let's
see. Okay, food truck late at night. I would say not a food truck, Whataburger.
Okay, I'm with that. Food, Whataburger, you can never go wrong.
I mean, there's not a food truck that I you know what? I take that back. Marcel, he's on the other side of town. But I don't even like go to that sound, that part of town.
Somebody said Jacob's drunk.
If he was able to,
you already know that's he took a four horseman. Like, come on.
Oh, Jacob, one of those nights again.
Not even my birthday.
Come on now. No, for the food trucks though, like seriously, like I like a. They're not even open late at night. So
some of them are.
The ones that I like are not.
Oh, okay.
Like Matt. Oh yeah, you know what? The ones that Steven taking me to, that was good. But if I had to eat late at night, it's a Whataburger. That's for me. You?
I don't really do food trucks late at night either because I feel like maybe I shouldn't trust it. But I have heard that on St. Mary's Strip, the one outside of, I think it's the gallery now. It used to be the Hard Bodies. I hear that one's life. Okay. I also hear there's one off of Data Point that's lit too. But if I'm doing late night food, it is either Whataburger or Taco Palenque.
Okay, Melvin.
Eddie's Tacos. Is the shit.
On that side of town.
You know that side of town. You got to go to that side of town to get them tacos. But Eddie's Tacos is the shit.
What as me?
Okay, so there's a new one that my sister just told me about, and it's in front of Woodrow's, and it's like a black truck. I don't know, but they're so delicious.
So if the viewers know,
Woodrow's on.
Woodrow's on Babcock or
yes,
Stono?
Babcock.
Babcock.
They're so good.
So chalk.
Okay, I don't know if anybody's Eric's Tacos on Nagadoja, bro.
Eric's
Tacos with the beans and the quesadillas, the Eric's Tacos. They have the megonadas on the other side. They got the anything you want. Eric's Tacos has it.
What happened?
All night and all day.
Eric's Tacos is one of the spots too. There's two other people that started as food trucks that are still out there. I think hustling. Wayne's Wings.
Ooh, shout out to Wayne. Shout out to Wayne.
There you go. And then my boy Jacob with Big Papa's, the Hood Rat Burger.
Yep.
Jacob's killing it too. They both now have, they're no longer food trucks, yet they're still doing their thing.
Hood Rat Burger?
You ever had the Hood Rat Burger?
You like hot Cheetos, right? You like hot Cheetos?
Sounds dangerous. Like a
hot Cheetos with nacho cheese.
Sounds like heartburn.
So it's like asada with hot Cheetos with cheese.
Sounds like the shits. Sounds
like
the shits.
You'll feel right in. Natalie's like, say no more.
Let me get a double order of the shits.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so we have one more question.
So I got the mic, Josh. I got two questions. One for Soulchild and one for Scott. Soulchild, what is your favorite event that you've hosted or emceed?
That's a great question. Honestly, I've had the honor of working at so many great events. I mean, especially what they were talking about earlier. I've had the pleasure of hosting Mind and Soul for 2 years. Had the pleasure of being involved with Silent Disco for 3 years. You know, I had the pleasure of hosting with almost every single DJ in the city. You know, almost every single Love and Hip Hop person from VH1, thanks to Toy. But one of my most memorable and favorite events that I've hosted, honestly, hands down, has to be the Oyster Bake, where we opened up for Sean Paul with DJ Genifier. That was over 60,000 people, and it was one of my biggest events to date, and it is definitely one of my most favorite and memorable, and one I'll never ever forget. So shout out to DJ Genifier for hitting me up for that one for sure.
All right, good question.
All right, Scott. So we know your promotions game is kind of in the past, but would you ever do another event or something in the one future
more? As far as a club night, where I'm at right now, we have it worked.
It's called just one. He doesn't even know it yet, but I'm gonna probably just share the idea. It's gonna be called Legends Night.
I think
night.
We just did like one big event.
Legends Night. We're gonna have all the like promoters from the past.
We'll see. The money ain't the same like it used to be either in the club. And I'm not saying I did it for the money, yet it's not what it used to be back in the day. So
it's true.
It's not even it's the people.
You know
like
you miss it.
Again.
Come on, man.
I miss it, yet I don't miss it. So it's hard to say.
You miss it, and then you go out, you're like, I don't fucking miss it. Never mind.
You
you're like, what the fuck?
200,000 homes.
You go out regardless, but what your future's going to be, what you want to do is what you're going to do.
Correct.
Going out is going out. You're going to do it whatever, you know what I mean?
And
whenever
where I'm
you
at right
do
now,
it.
When I go out, I'm like, nah, I'd rather be home. Because it's not what it used to be.
It feels good. So Netflix is $7 a month, so that feels good. It sounds good, too.
I think it'd be great if we did. I told John about this. John Veld, Nick Monroe, Paul Garcia. I was telling them all this. I was like, dude, I would love to do a Legends Night. Like, have every promoter from the past that don't promote anymore, and with some of the still current promotions, and then even introduce some of the young cats.
That's
like, there's a young promotional team. They're not active right now because they're all going through their own whatever. But Social Elites, like, I really like those guys. And you know, I think it'd be pretty cool to see, you know, a Scott Maloof and Paul and those guys be able to, like, hey, this is what
the
you
the OGs
do.
Versus yeah, you know, the youngsters.
Yeah.
Is that what you're trying to do? The OGs versus
even
the youngsters.
Even with Toy, you know, like everyone come together.
Toy is number one on the top in San Antonio,
so,
210.
So we do have our first special guest coming on to the show after we take a break, but you all know Toy. You all know Toy.
I heard about him.
Oh no, we're gonna have
so
to bring
I
this cat
know,
out.
So I want to know, like, what is something that you want to share about Toy before he actually walks up? Like, no, seriously, like, go ahead, ask me.
He is very social, friendly, and very welcoming. I can say, very, very welcoming, good-hearted person.
Okay, go ahead, Soul Child.
You never know. You know what, Toy? I definitely. I'm glad you asked that because, you know, I definitely owe a big part of my career to Toy, you know, because Toy is just the type of motherfucker to be like, well, come on. You know what I mean? Because he has these ideas. He has these visions. And, you know, when I hear him talk, it's definitely very inspiring. You know, so many events that he's put me on, and I can't even name them. I mean, Dezloaf, I mean, Plies, I mean, fuck, Miss Nikki Baby, Safari from Love & Hip Hop, Ray J, and Princess Love, and, you know, recently, Old Girl from Rhythm & Flow, Erica Mendez, recently, Old Girl from Rhythm & Flow, you know, so he's my definitely baby. Put me on to so many events, and, you know, that's definitely one of my, oh, you're right about that. I was looking at the comments. Sorry, I got distracted.
Go ahead.
But he's definitely one to put people on and show love to the city and always ask for everybody's opinion. And he loves blue Gatorades. I know that. Pink pussies.
Blue Gatorade.
You know, so, you know, you got to tip your hat to Toy. You know, people like Toy and Scott, because from the very beginning, when this used to be Broadway Bar, you know what I mean? Bro, he's been doing it ever since, you know,
yeah,
and every
over there.
Yeah. Every, yeah.
Okay, over there in the strip, whatever. Yeah. But at the end of the day, no matter what, I remember sneaking in with my fake ID to Broadway Bar. I remember
in
that.
The back. Hey,
yo,
the door.
But at the end of the day, you gotta tip your hat to him, because no matter what, he's definitely taking this and turned it into that.
It's a toy story.
He's definitely exactly
it's
taking
oh,
that and
right
turned
there.
It into this. And you got to tip your hat to it, because no matter what, the years have gone by, he's definitely gone through
Toy
the motions and did what he had to do, and still to this day is still doing it. So I appreciate him, and I'll always, you know, owe a big part of my career to Toy. So that's probably my biggest memory,
Scott?
I guess.
What about Scott?
I've known Toy since we were in high school. So back in high school, he would come to the team parties, and I mean, we grew up in the club. So I mean, I've been in the club since 13. TP was in the club. I mean, we were all Clifton was in the club. He called Zangy. He was in the club, and Cliff, both Cliffs were in the this club. Big, he was a bouncer, he was promoting. So it's we all grew up in there. But and Toy, I remember Toy when we were at Bar 11, he would come to the club with a Yorkie, and he would walk around the
you had a Yorkie?
Yeah, a Yorkie with him in the club all the time. Like, hell, he got a dog. Like, he just would come to the club. So I see my cousin Eli all the time, and I'm like, oh, Toy doing this. He's like, oh, with the dog? Because Eli in L.A. now. And he's like, and
what were you doing with a dog in the club?
It was part of his outfit, probably.
No, his mom told him, look, I'm going to go out. You stay home with the dog. He said, look, my mom, I have
I'm
to take the dog.
Well, he would come with the Yorkie, but then he would wear the tall tee with the spray-painted
Texas
shirt
Toy.
On. Yeah, Texas.
That's Texas Toy right there. That's Texas Toy.
Man, back
late
in
night.
The Texas Toy drinks at Broadway Bar?
Man, Toy. Toy, no, but we've always had love for each other since day one, and
now,
it's still love.
You all have seen different clubs and bars come and go within the years, over 10 years or plus. Yeah. What are some of your, what is one spot that you miss? Like, what's okay. one bar or club you miss?
Since you asked.
You know what? I know which club I miss.
Go ahead, Jordan.
You sound real intrigued.
Bro, you know which club I miss, honestly? Rio.
Club Rio, okay.
Club Rio.
Okay.
Bro, we did Club so Rio. Many events. Remember we did the all-white party with Amber Rose. We also did, that one was crazy from the bottom to the top. Everybody was in all-white. We also did Young M.A. We also did, bro, my uncle used to perform there back in the day with Metal and Chris Bettis. I mean, so many events at Rio from the bottom to the top. That's definitely one club.
Club Rio.
They turned it into a fucking...
Now
look,
you
I'm going to choose two because I'm going to keep it ratchet. I'm going to remember where I came from. Mirage and Broadway Bar. That's what I miss. That's what I miss.
We're definitely in the hood.
Give me the wet t-shirt contest.
Yeah. She already know. Hey. That's what we did at Mirage.
They say
baby.
Antro, Estilos, Rio, Suede.
Scott Maloof.
Those are all crazy. All the ones they're saying. Metropolis was one of the
Metropolis
best because they had that.
Where was Metropolis?
Was Rio. All that shit.
That was before I moved here.
Metropolis. I mean, because the VIP, they had this glass VIP that looked over everything. I mean, it was a really
Planeta.
Was fun. Even back in the day, like Observatory
Someone
and Excess and Diamonds.
Anthro?
Before Anthro, we had Diamonds. Dope. Then you had the Atrium, which had like 10 clubs in one. I mean, there was.
Oh, he's an OG.
So much.
Posh.
Back in the day. Posh.
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 Bar 11. I mean.
Bar 11.
Graham.
Joe Volcano.
What did fourth quarter used to be?
When we were in high school, Graham's.
Fourth quarter was a couple things.
Glow, Saga, the
Glow and Saga.
Soleil. Got 30 names in that bucket.
Empire.
Club Reigns. Gave us a Club Reigns.
We could keep
Empire.
On.
Pure was crazy because we were like, everyone was like 18 and like everybody was 21. So it was.
Your ID like, said they were 21.
It was literally like 18, 19, 20 year olds, but literally everybody was 21 in there. And it was just, it was wild back then. And the Soleil was very similar to that.
Tsunami.
So, Tsunami was where. That's where Diamonds was, where Anthro
was. That
was
the Grand. First club I ever went to. I was 12 years old.
Hey,
I
don't know. I like Corona. All Mexican. I like Corona.
What about you guys? What's name one place that you miss? That
Planeta and Mirage.
Okay, you?
I already named mine. I was Anthro. I was definitely Metropolis.
When you were SA Nightlife doing the...
SA Nightlife was...
With your sleeves rolled up and being in the middle of the circle.
SA Nightlife. I was 18 running wild.
Bar Central?
So the viewers keep on commenting what clubs that you miss or you were part of. Keep on watching. We're going to take another break.
You go to break really quick. Social medias. I know Esme already said hers, but
Esme says
hers.
So Soulchild and Scott. No. She already
said
hers.
You already said yours already?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. You can follow me on Snapchat. Please be 18 and over at The Real Jordan G. The Real Jordan G on Snapchat. Child of
Bombay.
Soul on Instagram. I'm serious because I DJ at a strip club, so I don't want to hear nobody's parents hit me up talking about like, yo, why you got my 14-year-old watching y'all snap? Just follow me on Snapchat if you're 18 and over, The Real Jordan G, and also on Instagram, Child of Soul.
All right.
So on Facebook, Scott Maloof. And then I have Maloof International Group on Facebook, too, so follow the business page. Instagram, S Maloof, and then we have Maloof International Group on both of those. Twitter, we got Scott Maloof. I don't really use Twitter as much as I should. And then that's where we're at. I just created a TikTok account, yet I don't know how to work it.
Oh!
Hey, nobody said Ice Lounge.
Gary V was talking about, I was listening to him.
Yes, Gary V.
He was like, in 5 years, I'm telling Instagram, no. TikTok, yeah. I was like, what? TikTok.
But so he's investing
I made one. It. Yeah, it's what he said.
TikTok is where it's at.
Hey, that's where I
haven't understood it
yet. I just started.
Because
my honest opinion. On that, real quick.
It's really about TikTok and Twitter coming up 2020.
My son got TikTok, so I don't like I don't want it's just
before we get into our break. I think TikTok is going to be another Vine or whatever it was. I don't think that it's going to take over social media. I think
Facebook
and Instagram. Just hear me out. Facebook and Instagram are always going to be the two platforms because our demographic that we want. The younger generation is going to be part of that TikTok and all the other stuff, the Snapchats and all that. I honestly don't think that.
Hit me up on Facebook.
So
Facebook's easiest for me.
You're
looking to buy a home, sell a home, invest in real estate, get at your boy.
Facebook is for the business. and the family and the, you know, Facebook's for the business and the family and the funny videos. Instagram is for the business. Twitter is for the business. TikTok is to get more of the clout. You know what I mean? But you got to, it's like I want to delete my Facebook, but then I see another video. I'm like, bro, y'all ghetto, but I love you. I ain't going to delete Facebook anytime soon, for sure.
So I want to give two shout-outs real quick. Right now, one, for those of y'all that watch me on Royal Slay, Snapchat, Instagram, that follow me, y'all know I'm family-oriented. Shout-out to my dad. If y'all need any upholstery work, headliners, seat covers, anything, Adam Upholstery on Blanco Road in front of the Sonic. And shout-out to all the soldiers that are out there right now, for real, because I have my brother that's in the Army and my brother-in-law. So shout-out to the soldiers right now that are going out there that didn't get to spend time with their family members on New Year's Eve. And New Year, so shout out to them, for real.
All right, there you have it right there. Thank you again, Esme, Soul Child Jordan, Scott Maloof. We're going to go on a break right now. And then when we come back, we're going to have Toy as our special
the
guest.
Toy store.
Everybody's Benji. Asking, they're like, bring Toy on. Where
toy
the fuck
store.
Is Toy?
Yes.
Toy,
know, Toy,
Toy, Toy, Toy. He's coming, man.
Down.
Stay tuned.
We'll be right back.
tiempo, siempre calientito, delicioso. Y a la gente, a todos les encanta. Es para todo tipo de público. Tortillas deliciosas hechas a mano. Es una maravilla. Realmente muy recomendable.
Gracias, vida mía. It was delicious. It was warm. It was amazing. Great service. And we just want to thank you for making our team building event amazing. Thank you.
Nigga, I didn't even see you, fool.
Okay, we're back again right now. Again, you had on our commercial, we had food.
I was gonna talk about power too.
Vida Mia Mexican cuisine, the bread box, barbecue, Sarita's Mexican restaurant. All the food looks good.
I'm fucking hungry now. I think we need some more food.
Why didn't we have a caterer for this? On set next time. So, yes, definitely we're going to have
this check mix. I want food.
I was going to talk about power, too.
But damn. You know what? It's amazing. Again, for the viewers and everyone that's watching, we appreciate the love and support. Continue to like, comment, and share. Also, tag some people that you would want to see this year, 2020, as a special guest. Some promoters, some event organizers, some musicians, some DJs. Anybody that you think that, you know, would be a great guest, tag them below so that we can go ahead and start working out some of the schedule. Now, we have the main event.
The main event.
Actually, we're going to be having the first official special guest on our show right now. Part one, because there's going to be a part two. And we're going to go ahead. I mean, he's promoted all over San Antonio. He's helped out a lot of different promoters. He's been in the game for 10 plus years. A lot of people said some great things about him right now. You, the viewers, are saying great things about Toy. Y'all want to say, where is Toy? Where is Toy? So we're going to bring up our special guest of 2020, Mr. Frankie Toy Martinez, onto the stage.
There you go.
Welcome.
There you go. Welcome. There you go. Over here, player.
Thank you for being here, for real.
We got you, baby. We got you.
What's up?
Yeah.
DJ?
Thank you for being here, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah.
DJ?
Our producer, DJ. AKA DJ.
That's the producer. I said the same thing.
DJ E flat over there. Thank you so much.
Yes,
of
sir.
Course, E flat. You know what? Thanks for coming on to the show, being our first special guest. It's great to have you on set with us, man.
Hey, ready? Yeah, man. You know, it's been a long time, sir. We're gonna talk about all your stuff. Where would you like to start off?
Actually, I want to know everyone that you've seen up here.
Oh, there you go.
Do you know who they are and what's your relationship and, you know, all of that good stuff?
My bad.
Relive.
I ain't a host. You know what I mean? I'm a Scott, you know what I mean? Scott, I mean, he was up here. I mean, he basically said how everything started and how I met him. I've been knowing him probably longer than a lot of people here. So, I mean, we go way back. I'm talking about charging me $20 for no ID back. Man, him and Billy, man, they used to.
Oh, yeah, they charge. They tax it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Him and Billy, man, tag team together, man, they used to. They used to make a lot of money off of me and my team. So, shout out to, man, that's crazy. But Soul Child Jordan, man, of course, man, he's been hosting all my parties, been doing really good. Esme, of course, know her because of Mystic. My brother from another mother.
Hey, you know he's gonna hit you up. Talking shit.
I mean, that's how I met her.
Yeah,
know?
True.
Broadway bar.
Facts. Truth.
Doing her little crazy dances, doing the Selena dance. But yeah, I mean, they all been great people with me. You know, every time I see them, it's always been pleasure meeting them, seeing them. You know, I mean, I always try to put my time with them, because Jordan, you know what I mean, like he's been like all over my, like the hosting uh-huh. thing, man, like he's just been like all over it. So it's been pretty good with him. He comes with some great ideas, comes in, hey man, I think you should do this, I think you should do that. So been pretty good with him too.
Oh, shit, that was my turn now? No.
I mean,
I was like, I know him for a long time.
Mel, oh, man. But you know where I met you at?
At Mom Marcus?
No, I met you at Downtown Club.
So,
the one in the rooftop. Which one was that?
No, we're at Taboo.
Reeve.
Taboo, oh, yeah, Taboo.
We're at Taboo.
That's where I met you.
Yeah, we're
That's
there.
That's where I met Taboo.
I don't know where we met. I just know we've known each other for a minute. But I
think
I
knew you with SA Nightlife.
SA Nightlife,
all right. SA Nightlife.
From Texas Toy.
I just met...
Yep.
At Drink Texas, right?
No, I met him last year.
Last year.
Not that long ago, but...
A week ago, and I'm
But I just met him, and it was crazy how we linked up.
Yeah. I'm trying to think of how we linked
Drink
up.
Drink Texas?
Well, no, Drink Texas, he came out and showed some love.
Yeah.
But before Drink Texas...
Oh, okay.
I'm trying to think, man.
Oh, was that V-Lounge?
Oh, V-Lounge. There we go. Jose.
Yes.
Jose. So, shout out to Hoffman Restaurant. And he has motors and like the cars and all dealerships. Shout out to Jose. Jose had reached out to me to come check out V Lounge. And when I went out there, he officially introduced me to you. Okay. And then that's when you and I talked and among us and all that good stuff. Yeah. And then after that, you came out and showed some love to
What kind of shot did you give me?
I don't know, man.
I think you gave something a crazy shot.
Yeah,
although
shot.
You're not drinking, he's like, I don't drink. I was like,
and yeah. Most people don't know that, you know, when people are taking shots with me.
Matter of fact, you were supposed to take a shot with me, and I seen the bartender throw some water in there, and I said, "Let me see that." You remember that?
Yep.
You made it look all good with the salt and
everything. That's exactly what I say. That's exactly what we were about to say. He dresses up real nice.
Yeah, because you think about it, you take.
I'm giving away your game, right?
No, it's okay. Everybody can know about it. It's just that when you take that water and you lick the salt and the lime,
makes the face.
You make the face.
Yeah,
I mean, you cannot.
I've done that before a couple times.
So, but no, it was great to actually finally meet you. And I told you this off camera, you know, because of the fact that I've heard of you. You know what I mean? So when Nat Boogie and Mel Finest with our beginning of the episodes and we were talking and throughout the whole year, your name would get brought in, you know, in the conversations. So when we were coming together for the 2020 and the live audience broadcasting, it was only it made sense to bring you on board as the first guest for our 2020 year. And because of the fact that you're going through a transition too, you know, you're going from promotions to retirement to now to the future. And just how we had Scott Maloof as our first special guest, which was a huge impact, because I think that actually influenced a lot of people to say, hey, you know what, if Scott's on it, then I'll go ahead and be a special guest too. And we had some great special guests that were that are here right now and that couldn't make it, of course. But to have you on as a first, I mean, we appreciate it. We love it. So
appreciate it.
Now,
yes, thank you.
A little bit about yourself and the promotions. What got you started? What made you? What got you into this promotion game? Like, what was it about it for you that was like, hey, you know what? I want to be part of this.
I mean, it started just in a VIP popping bottles. It started at Estilos. It started at Estilos. I think that was the first all white party. And I just started with the all white party, got all my friends, we got a limo, and we popped like 15 bottles that day. I don't know how I got home, but yeah, it was crazy. We was all in white, girls, guys, it was a crazy, crazy, crazy night. And from there, the club owner calls me. He's like, hey, you wanna do another party? I was like, nah, I don't wanna do no party. I'll come hang out though. He's like, well, bring all your friends out and I'll give you 2-3 bottles. Just come out here. I was like, all right. So from there, it started from there. And I went to the club and just started going. And I think we'd go to Suede. We'd go to Suede, mm-hmm. jump around from Suede to where you're at.
Yeah, Taboo.
And we'll come back. It was like a whole downtown was like the spot that time. Yeah. It was like everybody would be downtown. So from there, it was like from there in Estilos, when I was there, I'm trying to remember, man. It's been so long, man. It's just been.
Take your time, man.
It's been so long. It's just been like crazy.
But what
crazy.
Was it? What was it that attracted you? You know, was it the VIP lifestyle? You like, you
nah,
know.
No, honestly,
hey,
it was the girls.
The
you know
girls?
What I mean?
Okay,
it was the
yeah,
girls.
No,
you know what I mean?
Real. It was the girls. Keep it real. Yeah.
Honestly, it was just the girls hanging around with the guys. You know what I mean? Every week, just being in there, it was fun. You know what I mean? It was fun. And just next, you know it, the club owner came back and hey, gave me some money. I was like, that's what I gotta do. He was like, yeah, just bring people every week. Just keep bringing them. Next, you know it. I mean, I'm in the scene already. I'm in the scene and. And I took off from there, you know what I mean? I had a shop.
Was it Texas Toy Audio?
I had an audio shop. I had a Texas Toy Audio shop. I was doing tires, rims. And then after that, I branched off. I stopped doing that because, you know what I mean? Being in the night scene, it was kind of hard opening up the shop every day and stuff. So I ended up selling those. And then I just got more into the business. And after that, it just branched off and took over. And I was just like, you know what?
And what's the promotion team?
Team Wasted.
Now, yeah. How did you come up with Team Wasted?
It's just crazy, man. It was like crazy, just crazy. It was crazy nights. It was just crazy nights, man. Like, I mean, I wish I still had videos of those crazy nights.
Hell yeah. Phone parties and all.
Would you like have a, do you ever think about the social media, you know, how it is, like the Instagram and the Snapchat and all that? Like,
yeah,
you
because.
You would have had that 10 years ago?
Back then it was MySpace.
Well, yeah, MySpace.
It was MySpace. So MySpace was the thing. So it was pretty cool. The music and shit like that. You get on that shit. Music. So it was cool.
What now owning clubs or being part of the clubs? What was the best club that you have been a part of? That's Copa. You know, there's other clubs that you have owned. Which one was your favorite club?
I'm gonna say Bar 23.
Man, I had some good times at Bar 23.
Bar 23.
Yeah, Bar 23 was legit.
Really quick. You had what? You did 6'9" at Bar 23. Oh, I was thinking a different 69 or 69. I'm sorry. I was like, you did what?
It's past midnight, baby.
I mean, that probably happened too, but.
Yep.
I have a random question back because you were talking about MySpace. Can you remember who your top 8 was?
On the friend list? On the.
Oh, yeah. MySpace. Yes. Can you remember at that time who was your top 8?
Besides Tom.
Oh yeah, Tom. Wow.
Honestly, I don't remember.
No?
I don't remember.
Don't remember? Okay.
You remember the music that you were able to play?
Yeah, it was Plies.
Yeah, Plies. Busted Baby.
Okay. Busted Baby.
Yeah. Hey, did you have your Texas audio in the background?
I don't remember that.
So now you've been in the game promoting. Who are some of the promoters, even in the past or current, before you decided to step away, that you actually enjoyed promoting with?
Greg Teller was part of, you know what I mean? Greg Teller was really good. Me and him grouped up together and we started doing good things together. Trying to think who else. I think I did something with Scott a couple times. We did really good. Honestly, I was really by myself. Like a lot of promotion teams, they didn't want to tag team with me for some reason. They said I was too hood or.
Keep it real. Like, how do you feel when people put a stigma to you without knowing you? No, how does that make you feel? Like when someone says, "Oh, we don't mess with Toy," or "Oh, no, we can't do a promotion with Toy," you know? Do you like get mad about it, or do you like do you try to like, hey, just get to know me?
Nah, I just keep pushing. I mean, I just keep going. I don't even worry about none of that. I just keep going, bring the event out, and then. They'll figure it out themselves, you know what I mean? That when they see me bump heads and, you know what I mean, catch a shot or something like that, I mean, they'll understand me, and then from there, I'll go on. And then, I mean, I met a ton of people that like that. Like, man, I thought you were this, I thought you were that. And, you know what I mean, like, I mean, when I met you, you were the same way.
Yep. When I first met you, I was like, everything that I heard, I was like, because we kept it real. We were just like, hey, man, it was just so, like, one of those things that you don't know what you don't know until you find out what you should know. And you know, having the conversation with you and all that, I was just like, dang, like everyone like made it seem like you're a big bad wolf over here, and I'm just like, he's a chill guy.
Yeah. So I mean, when I used to go to the
clubs, Melvin was excited when we first met too, because Melvin kept on like, yeah, man, you gotta meet him.
Yeah, yes, my dog, that's my dog, got my back, man. Helped me out big time with the blessed gear. He always says, oh, you know, when I put it on, you know what I'm saying, all everybody's gonna want to wear it. let me see what happens. You know, he gets his big old cheesy smile. It's Toy, baby. And then, boom, all these people want it. And I'm like, all right, Toy, you got it, dog. You got it. I can't say nothing about it.
It was so crazy because everybody thought it was my brand. They would come there. Like, I'm like, it's not my brand. I'm just
get him 10%. Helping a friend out. You know what I mean?
He was right next to me. Yo, he was right. We were at Cantina. So we're sitting down. We're chopping it up. The table's right there. The dude's like, yo, I'm trying to get these hoodies or whatever, right? He's looking dead ass at Toy. So I look at that Toy like, damn, yo, Toy wants to get the hoodies. So he's like looking. And I was like, yo, so tell me how much they are. And Toy's like, yo, dog, that's not my brand. It's my boy brand. And he's like, so, Toy, how many do I have to get the hoodies? I said, oh, shit, Toy, this boy. It was a nice night.
Like, he really thought it was my brand. I was like, nah, I put something on, everybody think it's mine. Like, you know what I mean? It's always been like that since I was young. And everybody, when I start something, it just
takes off.
It just goes like that. I don't know why. I don't know how. It's just, that's what it's, I mean, that's basically where it goes.
Yeah. It was a good night, though. Cleaned
up. Yeah, you made some money that day.
I made some money. I've been waiting to get to you because of Toy. All right, cool. Shit, fuck with me. Let's get it.
Now, you had a Bar 23, and were you, was that your establishment? Like, you were the owner or?
I was a promoter.
Promoter?
Put it like that.
Okay. And then.
Smart answer.
Now, do you see yourself wanting to own another venue or anything like that?
No.
No, completely out.
No.
So, Toy, man, tell them how you're flipping houses, man.
Okay, there you go.
I mean, the house game, man, I'm on my first one, so when I get there,
it's
Scott's been on it and stuff like that, so we've been on it, so it'll be on the market real soon, so just something just to start. I mean, I always like flipping houses, you know what I mean? I always like the colors, the painting, everything. So something that I always wanted to do. So I'm gonna try it. I mean, if it goes from there, if it becomes bigger, then go from there.
Do you have anything else coming up that you want to let everyone know about?
No.
No? Okay. Okay, what about social media? You want to give out your social media?
Instagram, Toy210. Snapchat, Mr_Toy. And then Frankie Martinez on Facebook.
Now, where's Justin at? Justin, I want you to go ahead. I know there's some people out here that want to ask Toy a question. So go ahead, and anyone in the audience, again, participate. People that are watching, viewers watching, please ask a question. Right now, anybody that wants to ask a question. There you go. We have over here.
I got you. Since they asked this to everyone.
Tony, okay.
Oh, it's Tony. What's up, Tony?
What's going on, partner? Top five DJs.
Oh, shit. Yeah, you got to ask him. There you go.
They'd be exempt.
Damn, Toy, that's a good one for you.
I mean, I only worked with so many DJs out here, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, of course, DJ Mystic. Then I'm going to do DJ Free. And then I'm going to do X-Rated. CRG.
Got one more.
C1. I like C1.
I like C1 too. All right. Anybody else? Let's go ahead and get one more question in right now. Over here.
Cliff. Over there. Big Cliff.
What has kept you so humble with all the success?
That is a good question.
Yeah, that is a good question. You know what? I think it's just where I was born and raised at. You know what I mean? Just coming from nothing to something made me really humble myself. So, yeah, that was a real good question.
Respect. Anyone else before we go? Anyone else?
Okay, Esme. We have Esme.
Esme has a question. We're doing part two, so there's another part to this one.
Yeah, I got a part two.
My boy tired. I can see. Nah. He's like, yo.
Man, I've been up since 5 o'clock in the morning.
I know, I can tell. That's why I said the energy. I know he's like this. Come on, hurry up, bro. Trying to get through it.
So I want to know because I know, like, there's new generation that come in all the time, you know what I mean? So they go out, it's new kids, new people. What advice do you give for the new kids that are coming out?
For promoters.
That are wanting to come out into this?
I mean, really just keep your foot on the gas, you know what I mean? Like, you just gotta just keep going. Just don't believe nobody. Go with your own mindset, go with your own vision, because other people are always gonna be like, oh, do this, do that, but nobody's ever gonna pull out the money, nobody's ever gonna pull out the strength of how much you're gonna put into it. So, you know what I mean? Basically just keep going. Just keep going. Don't just keep fighting. You know what I mean? That's basically what I do. You know what I mean? I just
keep fighting.
Just keep fighting, you know what I mean? Just everybody's gonna keep talking.
One more question.
So what got you motivated to get started? What pulled you in? What made you say, okay, yeah, I'm gonna do this. Like, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna promote.
The money or the girls?
The girls.
I mean, the money and the girls.
Yeah.
Money and the girls.
I remember when I was coming into the promoting game, I was waiting in line with my cousin. We're at Joe's Volcano. And
oh, shit, that's an old school
and club. And we were waiting there, and I remember just seeing people get in real quick. And then I remember seeing, I think at Plan B, people were getting in real quick, too. And
shit.
When I met John, I was like, who are these guys, and why do they get in so quick? He's like, they're promoters. I was like, how do you get started? He got started because he was in fraternity and college and all that. I didn't go to college, so I was like, that's not in my map book at all, period. He's like, come on to my bar and my club and just start promoting. I'll show you exactly how to do it. But yeah, I think one of the main, when I got into it, it was like the money and the girls that got me into it.
And then afterwards it's just.
And then you look at the money and then you look at the business side of it and you look at, okay, how you can network. And then you start weaving in and out the good people, the shitty ass people, the people that, you know, have your back, the people that say that you have your back, but really don't have your back. So, you know, you start growing into.
You lose a lot of friends.
Yep, that's true.
Yep.
Really quick, thank you for being back. I do appreciate that.
Yes, Mel, good to see you, bro.
I think everybody's happy to see you back to yourself. So thank you for coming back. Social media?
Yes, my social media is unblocking everybody and accepting everybody back in my life.
Aww.
I went on. I ain't gonna lie. Your boy was upset. He was mad. And I blocked the shit out of a lot of people.
You blocked me too?
Nah, you on there. You on there, baby, all day. Davis. Pretty much, I blocked the whole Midnight Society crew. Everything. I blocked the shit out of them. But JT, the only one that lived. Yeah, JT, I kept JT on there. My man was going through something. I had to keep an eye on him. I kept an eye on JT when I was going through my thing. But yes, Melvin Johnson.
This is live, baby. This is live.
This is live.
This is live.
I blocked D-Maw's ass. I blocked his ass. But it ain't nothing new. Me and my man right there, we've been through some.
Man, shout out JT.
We've been through a lot. We've been through a lot, aquifer and everything. We've been through, yeah, you know. But yes, Melvin Johnson on Facebook, I am back. Boogie will get unblocked from all my social media.
Oh, man.
Yes. So Boogie is very excited about that. She'll be back on my Snapchat.
Can we get a hug? I need y'all to hug each other, man. I need y'all to hug each other. It's supposed to be love, man.
There you go, love. The viewings are going up. The views are going up.
See, they don't want us to leave. That's why.
You want to know something crazy? And I'm going to say this. I think probably some people already know this. There was one time before we actually started getting, like, you know, more and more and more, I told him, let's stage a fight. Remember all that? Remember that? I said, let's stage it.
And what? Hold on.
Shit, it happened in real, like, shit right here. I didn't have to say, like things were like.
I would say the thing when Mike Anthony said, let's stage a fight, I said, you know what happened the last time you said some shit like that? We had a problem. And he was like, what are you talking about? Talking about the A team and the B team thing. I said, all right, you can't be saying shit like that because people were. I said,
I know.
I told him, the thing is, when I said it,
it was like a friendly, like, competition. Boy, like, you should talk to your friends. Like,
yeah,
hey,
it was a joke.
A-T and B-T, it was really a joke. It wasn't for anyone to get sensitive. But
yeah, it was a joke. But
I mean, yes.
I know you guys loved it. But it was a joke. But I would say, like, I would say there was a lot of people that love Natalie. Yeah. There's a lot of people that love me. And when they saw us out, they saw us doing whatever we were doing, a lot of people were like, yo, bro, come on. You got it. And then, you know, on her side, people hit her up or whatever the case may be. I was like, look, man, this thing's we're having issues, and we'll be right back on the show and having a good time each and every Monday night at 10:30.
I just asked for your social media, bro.
I had to tell him. I had to keep it real.
Late night soap opera, ABC.
Yeah. But yes, Melvin Johnson on Facebook, Instagram, Mel Finest, Blessing Moore. Blessing Moore will be back at Cantina January 18th, just in time for the Conor McGregor fight. That's why I'm timing it perfectly, just like that. www.blessgearstore.com.
Before I give out my social media, I want to just say thank you for everyone that's here. Thank you for K-Rock again, Breathe Lounge, sponsoring our show. Thank you to our official DJ, DJ E Flat Music. He's one of the best talents out there. Also, thank you to our producer, Steven, for seeing the vision to be part of it. Thank you to Nat Boogie. Thank you to Mel Finest. This is the one-year anniversary. It means a lot to me. If you don't know who I am, please inbox message me. Let me know if you want to be part of the show so that we can continue to grow this. The vision is to continue to grow, to do more of these live audience shows. And also, thank you to all the special guests that were part of it in 2019. Thank you for part one with Toy.
Part two's
coming out on our episode 50. So that's going to be a big one.
Yep.
Social media, Facebook, MikeAnthony.Torres, or actually Facebook and Instagram, official MikeAnthony.Torres, and in the business side of it, at All Access MA.
Well, thank you for all that. I just asked for your social media as well, and you basically said everything I was about to say.
Damn.
Nah, but of course, my social media is Natalie Charlene on Facebook. Nat Boogie spelled N-A-T-B-O-O-G-I-A. On Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, all the extra shit. But yeah, like he said, thank you everyone for being here. I want to thank everyone that was a guest in 2019. We definitely appreciate you all being here because everybody's like doing something in this city. All of you are big influencers in this city. And we definitely appreciate you coming up here, taking your time to not just, you know, be on the show, but show up here and kind of just let everyone know what it is you do and, you know, giving us the opportunity to be one of the first one, only ones to interview you and kind of like, you know, get your your name out and the word out. And like you said, 2020 vision, we got a lot coming up, man. We are excited. I do want to thank everyone ahead of time that's going to be here in 2020, one of our guests. And of course, shout out to Mel Finest. Thank you for being here tonight. Of course, Mike Anthony, thank you for asking us to be a part of this. Shout out to my Midnight Society crew. I love y'all. Please check out the Midnight Society podcast every Thursday, 10:30 a.m. ish. And happy birthday again to my brother, Joshua. I fucking love you. Happy birthday. Guys that are still here, we do still have an hour to party, so we are going to celebrate his birthday. So please, please, please stick around so we can celebrate. E-Flat's going to provide the sounds. And once again, guys, thank you so much. Everyone that has tuned in all last year, it is our 1 year anniversary.
1 year, baby.
Crazy to say that it has been one fucking year. But thank you for everyone that has tuned in, everyone that interacts every week, and everyone that will tune in the future. Of course, it's Late Nights with All Access, myself, Mel Finest, and Mike Anthony. We hope y'all have a good night, had a happy new year, and we will see y'all next Monday. Y'all have a good night, guys. Peace.
Appreciate it.